Welcome to this video on calculating expression levels using RNA-Seq data with Geneious Prime. To calculate expression levels, you must first map your different sets of reads to a reference sequence. In this example, I have two sets of RNA-Seq reads, each from a different experimental condition. To map the reads as a reference, select the reads and the reference files. Then go to Align, Assemble, and Map to Reference. Ensure you correctly specify your reference sequence at the top. You can use the drop-down menu to select a different file in the same folder, or click Choose to select a file in another Geneious folder. If you're assembling more than one set of reads, you can choose to assemble each file separately by selecting this option. In the Method section below, specify the mapper you wish to use for the analysis. There are numerous mappers available in Geneious, each with its pros and cons. To learn more about these, click the Help button. For this example, I will leave these settings as default. In the bottom left, specify what level of trimming to apply before mapping. For this example, I will use existing trim regions. Lastly, in the bottom right, you can adjust what results should be returned from the mapping. When you're happy with these settings, click OK to run the assemblies. The resulting assembly report summarizes the analysis, including the number of reads assembled and not assembled. There are also two assembly files returned. You can zoom in to pan around the sequence on the contig view to see the aligned reads. Next, we will use the assembly files to calculate the expression levels of the different genes. To do this, select an assembly file, go to Annotate and Predict, and choose Calculate Expression Levels. In the new window, specify how you want to treat ambiguously mapped reads and the annotation type of interest. I will leave the settings as default and click OK. You should now see a new track created on the reference in the assembly file. Click Save to save your changes, and when prompted, choose to apply the changes to the original sequence. Because my two assemblies represent different experimental sample conditions, I need to run the Calculate Expression Levels analysis separately for the other sample. If you select both assemblies and run the analysis on both at once, Geneious will assume that these are a single sample and your calculations will be incorrect. However, if you have multiple reference sequences for each sample, such as one set of reads mapped to multiple chromosomes, then you should select all contigs from that sample and run them in a single step. Once you have saved these results, you should see different expression annotation tracks, one for each sample, loaded on the reference sequence and both assemblies. If you cannot see them, check that you have enabled the tracks in the Annotation and Tracks tabs. Mouse scroll over the track name to see information for that assembly. This includes total reads, transcript and fragment counts, reads per kilobase per million, RPKM, fragments per kilobase per million, FPKM, and transcripts per million, TPM. By default, expression annotations are colored based on the TPM property. They range from blue for zero, white for the mean TPM, and red for the highest TPM for any gene in the sample. Select the down arrow next to the annotation track name to color by a different property, and choose Color by Heat Map. Here you can choose a different coloring method, such as RPKM or FPKM. If you scroll over an individual expression annotation, you'll see a pop-up window containing the values for RPKM, FPKM, and TPM, and the raw read counts for that coding sequence. You can view these data in tabular format by switching to the Annotations tab. Then specify the track and adjust the data shown using the Columns drop-down menu. Finally, select Export Table to export this table as a CSV file. And that's how you calculate expression levels in Geneious Prime. To learn more, visit geneious.com.